to the Hoover Met, where Storm Team Chief Meteorologist Ashley Gann is on the WWBA National Championships. Ashley.
Big, big event going on right here in Hoover. We're at the Perfect Game baseball fields here at the Hoover Met Complex. There's 174 teams from across the U.S. here that have descended upon Hoover. They'll be here for a week. It's going to take 7 days for this tournament to play out. Today, 84 teams played, started at 8 o'clock this morning. They're going to continue through the evening. You can see the guys behind me right now warming up. We're going to talk to one of the ball players here in just a second. But first, let's dive into the forecast. It is a little on the humid side, although temperature's not too bad. Cloudy skies in Tuscaloosa. We did have a good bit of rain in West Alabama today, leaving the clouds kind of sticking around from Tuscaloosa west. Tuscaloosa temperatures were at 78, but now a fairly dry scan on our storm team radar right now. Heavier rainfall south of Valley Grande. We're going to continue to see that rain pushing south. You'll notice a mess of rain along the Florida Panhandle in southeast Alabama, but for us, relatively dry and quiet tonight. Birmingham, we're at 84 right now, 82 down in Alabaster, and those temperatures are going to remain pretty mild tonight, but those dew points are in the mid-70s, so yes, it feels a little sticky out there. Showers and storms possible south of I-20 through around 7 o'clock tonight, but otherwise mostly dry. Partly cloudy tonight. Morning lows will be in the 70s tomorrow, 74 in Birmingham. And for your Friday, temperatures by mid-morning already at 80 degrees, so ballplayers getting out here, you'll need to stay hydrated. All those parents and fans, make sure to grab the sunscreen too for those moments of sunshine. But chance of rain tomorrow looks greatest to our southwest, and then that will kind of taper as we move east and northeast. So just keep that in mind. Sporadic showers starting at around lunchtime tomorrow. Heavy rainfall there from Asheville down to Alex City. And then another wave of rain late tomorrow afternoon and early evening. We'll get a little bit of a break early Saturday morning, followed by a few scattered showers by afternoon. But the weekend's not too bad. I think at least the start of the weekend is a bit drier than the finish. We could see a few more scattered showers there for our Sunday into Monday. But then big changes as we move into next week. Here's your weekend forecast. 91 on Saturday. I know a lot of guys playing tonight. Hope they're still playing this weekend, and temperatures are going to be hot. Look at that heat advisory over in Texas. Some of our ball players here know that heat all too well. Excessive heat warning for East Texas because of that ridge of high pressure. That ridge moves in for us later next week, and it gets hot, hot, hot as we head towards the next 7 days. Rainfall for the first half of the forecast, and then a few showers will taper early on Monday, followed by heat returning mid to upper 90s by next Wednesday and Thursday, with those feels like temperatures back in the low 100s. And that is a look at your 7 day forecast. Now let's talk baseball. Joining me now is one of the players. Now tell me your name.
My name is Brandon. I go by BJ.
BJ. All right. Now tell me, what age group are you playing for?
I play a 14U five-star national.
And where are y'all from?
We're from Texas. Basically, we got players kind of all over the place, but, you know, we're mainly from Texas.
Okay, and tell me, is this weather okay for you?
Weather's great. Usually it's real hot. You know, out here in Florida, it's usually real hot. So
we're in Alabama this week.
Oh, my bad.
I know, but
oh,
you
bad.
Travel all over.
I'm sorry.
I know.
In Alabama, it feels.
And you
feels
love it, right? You love it here.
I love it. You know,
that's
I'm feeling
right.
Great. You know, I get to wear my little sleeves without being hot and sweating, so it feels
that's
pretty
right.
Good.
Now, I was telling you earlier, we interview a lot of young boys that are playing 7-8U baseball. What's a piece of advice that you would give those young aspiring baseball players?
For any young kids out there, basically just keep working, believe in yourself, never stop working, put God first in everything you do, and you know, you will succeed.
Excellent. Now, what grade are you in?
I'm going to the ninth grade, ma'am.
Well, best of luck. That was an excellent interview. Thank you so much for your time. Get in there and practice, and good luck this week. All right, that is look at our forecast live here from Hoover. We'll send it back to you in studio.
We just love BJ. He was great.
All of his friends had to give him some high fives, yes, for that great interview. Well, still ahead, an NFL star from